Putting accuracy first. This is Deuce 3 Weather.
Tornado watch in effect until 9 o'clock for all of southern Illinois, large part of southeast Missouri. And this is just the beginning of what I think is going to be a very long and stormy night. Good chance we're going to see severe weather. Very good chance we're going to see some large hail tonight. Damaging winds, pretty good chance of that as well. And I have to say, I think there's a pretty good chance as it goes when we talk about chances for tornadoes that we see a tornado, maybe more than one, in parts of southern Illinois or southeast Missouri. Nope. We don't know where. We just know somewhere south of I-64, there's an increased chance of seeing tornadic activity. Many times when we talk about storms, we're talking about fronts, or we're talking about the sun's been out and it's warmed the atmosphere. And a lot of the questions I've taken today are tied to that. What we're watching is something that you don't normally see. It's something that we have just started showing you here on WSIL recently, and that's this idea of low-level winds and looking for low-level jet streams. We think a lot of what's going to happen tonight, potentially, is tied to the low-level jet. So I'll put it into motion and show you that when we get to 11 o'clock tonight, not only are we looking at a very strong low-level jet coming in, but two of them and coming in at different directions. You hear us talk about wind shear. Here it is. It's pointed out in this beautiful map for you. Very strong winds coming in from the southwest and then a little more westerly in here. And when those run into one another, it just starts that wind shear. That can turn into rotation. Doesn't always, but it can. But 11 o'clock is a time frame that has shown up over and over and over again, and I am really focused on that 11 o'clock time. I don't think that's when it starts, but I think that's when we could see some of the worst, likely going to start before that. Cycle on through, get to 5 o'clock tomorrow morning, and once again, we have a couple of those streaks around, and anytime you have multiple streaks around, you're going to have some form of built-in wind shear. So we won't be completely done with the risk or threat of severe weather until all of this passes by, and that should be by 9 or 10 o'clock tomorrow morning. And then I think we start to think about things calming down. Cooler air actually expected to move in and start clearing skies out by afternoon. Right now on radar, we continue to watch the severe thunderstorms popping up. Large hail reported in these. They're showing signs they could be producing very strong winds. No signs of tornadoes in anything in this band yet. But if I widen the view out just a little bit, I did want you to see that near Little Rock, there is a red box that has just been posted, a tornado warning there. Remember where we were watching that jet streak coming from, coming up from central Arkansas and over the top of us. We may be watching that energy to actually be our trigger to bring in the chance of storms later this evening. Temperatures, certainly not what we expect this time of year. It's February, barely, but it's February, and we're looking at temperatures close to 70 degrees all across the region. Carbondale 69, not just warm, but it's muggy out there. The dew point 64, south wind showing up at 15. Gusts have been close to 30. Gusts tonight likely could be strong enough to be damaging, even if they're just straight line wind gusts. Certainly encourage everyone to be aware of changing weather as we move through the nighttime. Lots of clouds around, as you would expect. Skycast into motion. There's that increased chance. Look at the time again. 10 o'clock, 9 o'clock to 11 o'clock. That window concerns me for all of us in southern Illinois. Then it'll sweep off through western Kentucky at 4 o'clock in the morning along the front. Another chance moves through. All of these are chances. We didn't draw the colors in here, and that's what happens, but it's what we're projecting at this point and want everyone to be aware and ready for all of that. And again, one more view on radar showing those strong storms moving through south central Missouri. They'll continue to move this way, and our chances go up. Tomorrow, the chance of storms in the morning sweeps out pretty early, as a matter of fact, although it could impact some students going to school. We'll have to see just how long it lingers. Falling temperatures in the afternoon, and then for the rest of the week and the weekend, it's cooler and drier with a warming trend just in time for the weekend. I'll think about that tomorrow. We got to get through tonight.
We sure do. Thank you, Jim.